Well, all right, all right, all right. Here we are, heading into the Refind. This store is located in Smithsburg, Maryland. Right inside the door, I see a gorgeous tea set. This really appeals to my inner Beetlejuice fan. Anything black and white stripe gets me, but above and beyond that, it's gorgeous. I like the polka dot pattern. Things are reasonably priced. We have the cream and sugar, the teapot, and multiple teacups. Now, everything is priced individually, and I would hate to think somebody would break up the set, but I guess you could do that. I think somebody definitely needs that. Up here, there's some pressed flower art. Home sweet home. Some random mugs. What do we have here? Give us this day our daily bread. Nothing here really appeals to my personal style, but $4, that's kind of nice. Not really my thing. Cute little teapot there. I like that yellow color. These are attractive. They look kind of bronze, but they are plastic. Good price. That home interior vibe. People have been really digging on that home interior vibe, though, here lately. So I can appreciate that. Little hummingbirds. They're cute. I like the larger set better than the smalls. I love coffee. Yes, I do. These kitties are cute. They are brass. $7. Oh my gosh. Look at how pretty this is. Wow. That's like hand-painted floral pattern on there. They look like they're in really good shape. I love that green glass. That's gorgeous. Is this cherry blossom something? Like a little light shade of some sort? I don't really know what that is. Some hat boxes. That mirror's pretty. It looks like it was a tray that somebody made that you can hang it on your wall. It's pretty though. It's really heavy. I like it better as a tray than a wall hanging. But I don't think I need that today. Little Tiffany style lamp. There's another mirror. It's kind of nice. That's just plastic. Lightweight. Oh, out of focus. There we go. They have a small kind of clothing section in here. I like that bag. Got a thing for yellow. This one's kind of neat too. Not really my style, but kind of cool. I mean, when you think about it, this is a Goodwill store, so the prices are still extremely reasonable. Not seeing anything that I really need to have, but that's the cool thing about this place is it's small. And there's constantly new things coming in. It's kind of pretty. I was here the other day and people were buying stuff up, and as stuff was going out, stuff was coming out from the back. So it's pretty cool that they're continually stocking. All right, so here we are, done and ready to check out everything that I found today. So let's get into it. At an estate sale, these cute little guys, Home Co. Puppy and Home Co. Deer. At the Goodwill in Middletown, I found these enamel flowers in a heart vase. They are marked 1977. And these beaded flowers in a cherub vase. This federal glass vase, yellow and white stripe. Pretty tall. And this really nice collection of runes with a pouch. Rune stones. You know how to use rune stones? I also found these really nice looking bird wall plaques. I found this clock at a yard sale. I love that you can see the mechanism in there. This quill pen, multiple attachments, but it has that whole like steampunk vibe to it. It's actually in really good shape. Very cool. Look at this decanter. I think it probably had a stopper at one point in time that it does not currently possess. But all these little intricate hand-painted flowers, you can feel that. And the gold, made in Italy. It has four of these little glasses. I just think they're gorgeous. Such pretty green. Now let me flip you around here real quick to show you the few other things that I got. Check this out. This vintage bread box. It has a little rust and a little damage here and there, but it cleaned up really nice. I love it. And lastly, I found this little boy. He doesn't have any antlers. They are actually there, but very barely there. And we're not a normal like white-tailed deer by any means. We are something a little bit different, a little special. Because Bucky here is a white-tailed deer. And as you can see, they look very different. So I need to do a little research. I had somebody asking about my taxidermy, and I do have a few butterfly pieces. Can't see really well, but I do have a frog wet specimen and a few moth butterfly specimens. But as far as like full body taxidermy, I don't have a ton, but I have Stinky the skunk, and I have my jackalope. I do have this full body guy over here. He's actually quite large. I have a bat. He's in a protected dome. And I have this fox. I also have an alligator, but he's behind some things that I can't get to show you. But I know a lot of people are against taxidermy, but when I find taxidermy in flea markets and yard sales, estate sales, and it's really inexpensive, I feel like I need to take it and have it be appreciated, because these animals went on to do something else, to be something else after their life. And for them to just be sitting in a flea market, like Bucky was literally on the bottom shelf in a flea market, and he had spider webs on him, and he had a $20 price tag on him, and he wasn't even hanging up, he was just on a shelf. And I was like, oh my gosh, he can't be here. So I appreciate them. And I don't know, if it's not your bag, so be it, but I definitely can appreciate it. So thanks for paying attention to what's going on with me. I feel very blessed that everybody's been very supportive of my channel and my consignment booth,
and I'm really having a good time with it. So thanks so much for watching. You guys have a great week. Bye. I almost forgot this other thing I found. This was at a yard sale. I ended up talking the lady down. It's super old. It has that kind of concave front and back to be able to get a good grip when you're bringing it out. And it does have a design on it. And it is old. I need to do a little research on that. The cap, even. It does have a patent. Patent September 15th, 1931. It's huge. It's really big.